guys, today I'm going to show you how to make my rosemary clodagh bread, which is my variation of the traditional Irish soda bread. It's such an easy bread to make. Anybody can make it. It's really just weighing, stirring around, shaping and banging in the oven. I promise you, you'll have it prepared within like 10 minutes. And I think especially now, we all want to have some fresh bread. And this way, you can be making it whenever you want it. So I've got wholemeal flour. I have 350 grams of wholemeal flour. I've got 250 grams of white flour. And then I've got some bicarbonate of soda, and that's the raising agent. So I'm putting in 2 teaspoons of bicarbonate of soda. These are all store cupboard ingredients, so you can really stock up in these. And then I'm going to mix all these together. It's really important that you mix the bicarbonate of soda into the flour. You ask why? And the reason is so that the bread will rise evenly, and also so that you don't get clumps of soda within your bread, because then that creates kind of little green spots. Maybe you've made soda bread before and you've got little green spots in it, and that's because your bicarbonate of soda isn't mixed in properly. The other things that you could mix in here are, you could put in a little bit of rye flour, you could put in some seeds like pumpkin seeds or sesame seeds or sunflower seeds. But this is the classic recipe, so this is the one you want to master first, and then you can go mad on all your different variations like I do. I promise you, you know, making bread like this is so calming. I'm trying to keep my energy up during the video, and this is just making me melt, because the feeling of the flour through your hands is just really, really relaxing. So if you're looking something relaxing to do, this is definitely a lovely thing to do. Okay, so that's mixed well. The next thing I pop in, I'm just gonna get my chopping board, is fresh rosemary. I love adding fresh rosemary into this because it adds a beautiful sweetness. I love the flavour of rosemary. You probably notice I add it into lots of my different recipes, and it grows so easily. So it's definitely something you could be planting out right now. So taking all the leaves off the rosemary, like so. I want 2 tablespoons. I want 1 for the actual mix of the bread, and then also some for on top, which I sprinkle over to give that lovely rosemary crust on the top of it. If you don't like rosemary, you could add in fresh thyme, you could put in dried oregano, or else you could just leave it herbless if you want to. So just chop it up lovely and finely. Loads of fresh rosemary growing, what I tend to do is chop it all up like this, add it in with a mix of sea salt and put it into a jar besides my cooker, and then I'll sprinkle it over like roast chicken or lamb cutlets for like some extra flavour. Okay, that's my rosemary, and I'm going to put half of it into my mix like that. The rest of it I'm going to hold back for when I actually have my bread made. Pop that there. Okay, so the last thing we're going to do is just mix in the fresh rosemary, and then we make a well in the center like that. Okay, so you've got your well made, and then we move on to the liquids. So traditionally in soda bread you use buttermilk, so if you can get buttermilk, fantastic. It's a really great store cupboard ingredient because it lasts for about a month, so that's quite handy to have. Stock up on that. Otherwise, I use milk and yogurt. I have 350 mils of full fat milk, and then I have 250 mils of yogurt. You could use Greek yogurt or natural yogurt. You just pop that all in. The other way to make buttermilk is by adding the juice of a lemon into the whole milk. That also makes buttermilk. That goes, and I whisk it all around to get the two of them mixed together very well. Okay, that's enough. Back to the bowl, and I use a fork for this. So I put my fork in the well, and then I slowly mix in the milk, allowing the flour to absorb all the liquid. So
just do it slowly, allow the flour to catch up. And the texture that you want is moist, but not sloppy wet. I'm just gonna put this down for a second so I can use both hands, one to hold onto the bowl, and then just mix in all the flour from around. So it's the complete opposite of what you might instinctively think about bread. Like, you know, we think about kneading, etc. You do that when it's yeast breads and sourdough breads, but for soda, it's the opposite. You want to kind of work it as little as possible, hence why a fork works really, really well. But still a bit dry. Add in more liquid. And when I get the perfect consistency, I'm going to show you. What you don't want are any dry spots, so kind of use your fork to kind of go through it to make sure there are no dry spots in there. And that's it. That is how moist we want it to be. Can you see that, guys? It'll be a nice big plonk. It's kind of like porridge that's been cooked for too long. You know, that needs more liquid. That's what it looks like. Okay, take this away. I'm gonna get my baking tray. And on the baking tray, I'm gonna put some wholemeal flour, and that will stop the bread from sticking once it's baked. Sprinkle it on. I think that one of the positive things about us all being, you know, isolated and having to stay at home is that you can learn all these new skills, right, that you've always wanted to do. And I'm really hoping that this video is going to make you, you know, master the skill of just making your own fresh bread, you know. And it adds so much, I don't know, I think it adds so much happiness to the house. I always say that baking bread at, you know, in your house turns a house into a home. So the smells wafting around the whole house like a siren. It's gorgeous. Now, once I've put that out on the tray, what I do is I wash my hands with flour. And what that does, it makes my hands into these great tools for shaping up the bread, right? So I'm gonna collect a little bit of the flour, bring that back underneath it again if it all starts to gather around the sides. And I want to make this into a roll. And then once you've got that like that, your hands just going like that, twisting it around, turning it upside down, being really, really light. Just always think of lightness. You want this bread to be lovely and light. Turn it around like that, and then with your hand, gently pat it down to 2 inches. I mean, it doesn't matter if it's 2 inches, 3 inches, or 1.5. You know, it's about that much, but you know, don't get too worried about that. And then the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to cut the bread into quarters. In Ireland, traditionally, we say this is blessing the bread, which I think is such a beautiful way of thinking about it. It's just, you know, your moment to give thanks that you have these ingredients to make bread for your home. Okay, so we're making the cross, but it also is very handy, because once the bread is made, you can break it easily. You know, if it's only you at home, or if there's just two of you, you can break it up into 4 pieces, freeze the other ones, and they defrost like within 10 minutes in the oven. So I've got my bread there. Now, bring back over your liquid, which is, you know, your buttermilk mix or your yogurt and milk mix, and you should have about that much milk left over, okay? And you get your pastry brush. If you don't have a pastry brush, just use your fingers like this, okay? So don't get worried if you don't have a pastry brush. Just dip it into your fingers like that and pat it on nice and gently. Otherwise, with your brush away and paint your bread lightly with the milk. Now this does 2 things. It gives that beautiful golden colour to your bread, and it also gives that lovely crunchy texture that you get, or that you will get when you make this.
Do many of you break bread at home? I'm not sure if you can comment on this video. I guess you can leave a comment underneath on my Instagram, but I'd love to know if you are starting to make bread at home, or if this is something, you know, that you're deciding to do now that we're all stuck at home. On it goes. I'm so into, you know, matching music with whatever I'm cooking or baking. This is Jack Johnson, who is, he's just my bread making music. It's like, I don't know, it's lovely and relaxing, and it totally gets the whole kind of baking bread vibe. I always get my candle lighting. I'm so into having candles always lit when I'm, you know, feeling a little bit blue or a little bit anxious. It just immediately makes me feel a little bit more calm. Anyhow, we'll do whatever we can, won't we? So okay, that's completely coated with the milk mixture like that. And then my rosemary. Do you remember when I chopped up my rosemary? I left half of it left. So I'm gonna sprinkle that all on top. So the other variations that I was talking about that I do are seeds. So you can put, like, I think I've got some here actually. You could put, you know, sunflower seeds, you know, you could sprinkle over, you could put on pumpkin seeds, you could put on sesame seeds. There are lots of different seeds that you could use. The other thing that I want to add is sea salt. So I don't put salt in the bread because the soda is actually a little bit salty. I like putting a sprinkle of sea salt, good quality sea salt, on top, because it gives that lovely crunch. Now, before you start making this, you need to preheat your oven. So don't put this into an oven that you've just turned on. Make sure your oven is piping hot. I put it up to 200 degrees Celsius, which is quite hot, for 20 minutes. And I just keep an eye on it. And then I turn the heat down. And what that does, it rises it. It gives that gorgeous golden color. And then I turn it down to about 150 degrees Celsius for the remaining 20 minutes. And then that cooks it all the way through. And I did it literally an hour ago, just before we started making this video. I made my bread. And just let me put this aside. I'm coming right back. And yeah, so this is the bread I made an hour ago. It's still warm. Honestly, it's such a cinch to make. You know, when I first started training to be a chef, I used to have a stall at the farmer's market in Middleton, and the very first thing I started making was this. I used to get up at about 5 in the morning on a Saturday morning, bake this bread and sell it. And you know, and I was only learning at that time, and it's so easy to make, but I'm going to break it for you. So traditionally in my house, at the table, when there's somebody new who hasn't been to my home before, they get to break the bread. And so this is how you break the bread. Look at that. Oh, isn't that gorgeous? And the smell is so lovely. I'm just gonna take a little crunch. Oh, it's so good. I'm gonna get a little sprinkle of the sea salt from the crust and the rosemary. And I do love the texture of the crunchiness, and then kind of very, you know, soft on the inside, but it's also quite airy. And I love the wholemeal flour. It feels so wholesome. The other benefit for all of you out there who are always worried about their tummies like I am, is that soda doesn't make your tummy bloat like yeast does. So this is a good one for all of us, and freezes really well. Hope you've enjoyed it, and get baking bread.